26 police service personnel. We actually need 28,000 more. This year, we are told they are going to recruit only 4,000 people. Now, out of this number, only 6,900 of them are properly accommodated. And I recall, your government promised to build them houses. Well, we at the time at Imani suggested that the conceptual framework for building accommodation for the police unfortunately did not meet all the financial requirements. There's been several years on, and the police service is still in atrocious state. There are only seven weapons. Well, there are seven police personnel to a single weapon. And I've been reliably informed that most of the weapons are typically Second World War type weapons. And there are only a few police posts. We have about 1,700 and over of them. Only a few of them actually have communication handsets. And I'm happy the Deputy Minister is here because he doesn't like to be defeated at all. I know from my personal relations with him. So I'm sure he's going to make sure that the police service receive adequate communication tools. Now I'm saying this because you see the Article 200, subsection 3 of the 1992 Constitution says that the police service shall be equipped and maintained to perform its traditional role of maintaining law and order. Frankly, I think successive years have shown that the police service is indeed not a service that is befitting of the country that we have. I was reliably informed that in 2016, there was no operational budget given to the police service to help with elections, but of course they delivered. And in 2017, they received zero funding for operations. I am very hopeful that this banner headline we saw today and the presence of the Deputy Defense Minister, he's smiling, I'm sure will change the fortunes of the police.